Hi everyone, today I'm working on some free motion quilting spiderweb designs on these fun scrappy pillows that are made from leftover Halloween fabrics from my Dizzy Dazzle quilt. So I thought it would be fun to show you a quick tutorial on how I do this design. So I'm working on a Juki and I have all of my settings for free motion quilting. And I'm going to start by sort of trailing in and prepping the start of my first web. Okay, so to begin a web, what I'm going to do first is create an hourglass shape that has a curved top and a curved bottom so that the curves are both angled in towards the center. So to do that, I'm going to curve over, down, over, back up to where I started. Okay, so you can see here I have this hourglass shape with the curved top and the curved bottom. So now I'm going to come out, I'm going to make the top curve here and come across and make another curve on the other side. This is going to be a six-pointed web when I'm done. So I'm curving out, coming across the middle, and then up to the top of the other section. So now I have 1, 2, 3, 4 sections. So now I'm going to come back down diagonally up to complete my 5th section, across and back down to complete my 6th section. So now I have all 6 sections of my web, and I'm going to backtrack in and I'm going to repeat that twice so that I get those interior curves and I have sort of a 3-tiered web. One time around, I'm gonna go in a further. Second time around. And then I'm gonna come back out. So I started up here, and I'm gonna come out the diagonal end, opposite where I started. So here we have one finished web. So now I'm gonna trail over and do another web. So I'll move a little bit faster on this one. So I'm gonna start with my hourglass. Okay, so I'm back to where I started. I'm gonna do my top 2 sections. Cross. Back up. And then diagonally down, completing my final 2 sections. Okay, so now I'm going to come in and do my 2 inside rungs. Out the other side. So now I can sort of rotate and work my way across somewhere else. So you can see here's the first web that we did. all complete. It has 6 points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and then 3 layers, sort of the outside layer, and then 2 inside layers of webbing. And you can see this is what it looks like from the back. Okay. So we'll do a couple more here so you can just see how they go. Okay, so I've done 4 webs in total here, and I'm just going to keep working my way around, filling in spaces until I feel like it's good to go, and then I might come in and do just a little bit of loop-de-loop design to sort of fill in areas that don't have webs. Now, I'm not an FMQ master. This is all just for fun, so you could, of course, be much more particular, use a ruler to trace over your lines and get yourself really exact points. I'm just sort of winging it, so, you know, my lines are not perfect, but they're fun, they're quick, and they're pretty easy to do. So I hope this has been a fun tutorial and inspiration for some of your Halloween quilting projects.